We're off the coast of Miami on a huge swank yacht decorated in a sinister Little Mermaid motif.
Mr. Fish. Mr. Fish, we're pulling into port.
Excellent. Spread 'em, boys. Oh, Miami. Spectacular city. Filled with international trend-setting millionaires, supermodels on rollerblades, and decadent teenage movie stars. Every single one of them salivating for the next big fad. Too bad. They all have to die.
Spy Groove, file number Bufant 17Z. Code name, Move Over Miami.
Butterscotch.
The Maxi Bar. A mod masterpiece of underground hipness.
Really? Yeah. I just throw out a name.
Any name that you would say, I would probably.
Agent number one, agent number two.
Charlize.
Agent number one. And agent number two discuss classified surveillance information.
Tyra.
Glazed.
DiCaprio.
Cream-filled.
Marilyn.
Manson or Monroe.
Manson.
Powdered, jelly-filled, 3 days old.
A three-day-old donut.
Eats the jelly first.
No way.
I have video footage to prove it.
Oh, see? You were twisted.
Spending hours and hours going through video footage to find out who likes what donut might seem twisted.
No, it does seem twisted.
To someone with your sort of problem.
Hey, boys.
It's Mac, one part urban cocktail waitress, two parts Lady Godiva, with a dash of cayenne pepper.
Where you been?
Places.
What'd you see?
Things.
How come you never bring me nothing?
'Cause you got it all, Mac.
Oh, but the one thing I really need.
Yeah? What's that?
Your drink order?
Oh,
the usual.
Okay, what sort of problem?
I'll tell you later.
Is that me or you?
Me.
It's Helena Troy.
She's the brains behind the operation. Without her, the agents would be nothing more than two extremely hip gas station attendants.
Something fishy's going on down in Miami.
Fishy as in Mr. Fish?
That ego-driven, trend-chasing clubhound has been buying up huge tracts of oceanfront swampland just south of South Beach.
Building a vacation home?
Honey, evil doesn't take a vacation.
In fact, Fish has hired himself a top-of-the-line maniac.
Name?
Rock Debris.
Occupation?
Well, it's more like a fetish, but the man gets paid big bucks to blow things up.
There's nothing like a sociopathic mercenary who enjoys his work.
I want you boys to slip into the Miami scene, find out what these two are up to, and shut them down pronto gusto.
We're there, Chief.
Remember, boys. Fish used to do a hypnotist bit on the Sonny and Cher show, and he was damn good at that hypnotism thing. Be careful.
Careful is my mother's maiden name. Looks like we're heading to Miami.
Let's go, go, Flamingo.
Agents cruise through South Beach in their 1974 eye-catching lime green luxury convertible!
Maraschino cherry cap.
Check. So, what's this problem you think I have?
I'll tell you later. Sonic umbrella mic.
Check. What is my problem?
GC surveillance shades.
Check. What's my problem?
Ricky Martin inflatable decoy.
Hip pocket. What is my problem?
Patience.
I don't want to be patient.
No, you have no patience. That's your problem.
I have patience.
Could you spend hours and hours studying donut surveillance footage?
No, because I'm not a twisted person.
No, because you're not a patient person.
Whoa, hit the rewind. I spy the catch of the day.
Hello, waitress.
The Aqua Lounge.
I order a dry martini. This one is sucking wet.
Just your average South Beach-style cocktail bar filled waist-high with sparkling Evian water.
I am a patient person, you know.
Okay. Prove it.
Using a miniature camera hidden inside Fish's Shirley Temple, Agent Number One snaps high-res digital photos. A teeny-tiny omnidirectional microphone garnishing Debris' girly drink transmits a microwave signal to the agent's limited-edition Stussy surveillance shades.
What? You know what I'm talking about, Rock? What's the name, starling?
Drunk Offerathus Barcase couldn't get a pocketbook to stay on her shoulder. The damn thing's hanging off her butt. Flash, flash, and there's what's-the-name in the morning papers. The next thing you know,
Fanny Pack Ferdin.
Okay, you're right. I don't have the patience to listen to this sort of useless information.
Okay, I'm right. Now, thank you. Just shush.
And thanks to you, Rock, the next fad will be mine.
All with the touch of one red button.
At midnight tonight, splash. Bye-bye, Miami.
Whoa. Midnight tonight, bye-bye, Miami.
See?
Patience.
Well, if it isn't Lucy and Ethel eavesdropping at the Brown Derby.
I thought I smelled something.
Hello, Fish.
And goodbye, Agent Number One, Agent Number Two. Goodbye.
Okay, let's catch him.
And?
Catch him.
And?
You know, catch him.
Okay, how about we collect some information, maybe find out why Fish is out to destroy Miami? Then we could put together a plan that would actually stop it before it happens.
But they're getting away.
Right. Patience. Robotic killer sea monkey. Just add water.
Spy Groove. File number Buffon 17C, Part 2. In the Aqua Lounge, the agents are ambushed by Mr. Fish's robotic killer sea monkey.
Okay. Plan?
Working on it.
Agent Number One whips out his voice-activated agency guide to villains.
Access data.
Voice confirmed. Category.
Robotic killer pets.
Listing. Radioactive bunny. Atomic vomiting chihuahua. Robotic killer sea monkey.
So, how's that plan coming?
Open sea monkey file.
Opening file. Robotic killer sea monkey. Armed with a razor-sharp trident and titanium teeth. Can chew through the average secret agent in 3.2 seconds.
I'm trying to be patient.
Emergency deactivation.
Deactivation. By accessing interface module hidden in left butt cheek.
Did you deactivate the interface module in the left butt cheek?
Sorta.
The agents search the skies for Fish's helicopter using their variable altitude frequency selective radar. Available to sharper image.
We lost him.
They pass a palm tree and a juice bar.
We were sitting right next to them, and then we lost them.
They pass a palm tree and a juice bar.
Got anything?
They pass a palm tree and a juice bar.
Now, so, tell me. We knew exactly where they were, but we didn't have enough information. Now, we have information, but we have no idea where they are. Which is better?
Please, I'm
still working on that plan to save me from the robotic killer sea monkey back there?
No, I'm
because there was one part of the plan that really didn't work for me. The gathering information from your handheld while the little monster was ripping out my throat part. That was a little bit awkward. Don't even think of telling me to be patient, Mr. Information Junkie.
You don't have to be patient. I have him.
Location?
Somewhere in the vicinity of directly behind us.
The agents hang a sharp left into an outdoor shopping area packed with posh pedestrians.
Welcome to the Biscayne Bay Mall open-air shopping experience.
Good afternoon, Agent Number One. You're looking good. Processing cherry cam photos.
Thank you.
You good over there?
Oh, yeah. I'm checking out those photos from the cherry cam. What is he looking at?
What?
To get a closer look, Agent Number One activates the windshield / digital display screen.
What is that?
What?
It's an architect's rendering.
Of Miami.
Are you sure it's Miami?
Yeah, that's Miami, all right. See? Palm tree, juice bar, palm tree, juice bar.
Hmm, what does it say?
New Miami.
New Miami? They're heading up to sea.
And so are we.
Dry spy activated.
I'm so glad we finally get to use this feature.
I know, it's so,
Chitty chitty bang bang.
Yeah.
I hope it works.
We have to get on that ship.
Time for plan B.
What was plan A?
What the? I'll tell you later. Have we dropped anchor? Excellent. Open the outer doors. Don't you just love it? And now I'm off to my cabin to slip into something a little more appropriate for wiping out an international fern mecca. Rock, refuel the hover boy.
Oops. Hey,
what?
You think there'll be a big fight?
There's always a big fight.
You think there'll be snacks?
Below deck, the agents strip off their wetsuits to reveal Spy Groove evening commando outfits, courtesy of Diesel.
Dynamite. Nitro. A cordless torpedo.
Oh my God.
Welcome to New Miami. Enjoy your muffins.
Muffins?
Wow, this is getting serious.
Locked. Damn. Fish is behind this door. I can feel it.
I can read it. It says private/fish.
All we gotta do is bust down the door, and we got him.
Ah! Wait!
What?
How are you gonna stand when you get inside? Are you gonna stand, like, you know, down, you know, like this?
No. That's way too,
Steven Seagal?
Yeah.
Ew.
In one of those moo-moo jackets.
Ew. Okay, how about like this?
Perfect. Total Johnny Quest. Let's cut bait!
The agents bust down the door and find themselves in a huge swinging salsa party, fully swamped.
Look, snacks.
Spy Groove, file number Buffon 17Z, part 3. Surprised by a celebrity-laced salsa bash, the agents have no choice but to do what they do best. Mingle.
Hi,
Ms. Clem.
Boys.
Check out Dawson's Creek.
Actress Rosario Dawson, Antonio Sabato Jr., and the entire insane clown posse snorkel for apples in a huge aquarium.
Check out that frozen freak.
Now might be a good time to tell me the rest of Plan B.
Why? Hello? Because everyone is staring at us. How are you?
Agent Number Two deploys the Ricky Martin inflatable decoy.
There's
Ricky. Okay, busting down the door was plan B.
That's it? Bust down the door and then nothing?
Tell Sabreeze, if it isn't the Olsen twins of the Espinars world, just the perfect addition to my little crime-free salsa bash.
I would have brought a date, but your little robotic sea monkey friend lost its head.
Pity. Where's the other monkey? Rock? He's not what you'd call a people person.
Pity.
Well, I hate to interrupt our subtly adversarial conversation, but I see a conga line forming. Stick around, boys. I've got something splashy planned for later.
So, are we still doing Plan B?
I don't know what you're doing. I'm being patient and gathering information.
To use for your famous Plan B?
I'm not going to tell you.
It obviously won't work or we'd be doing it.
How do you know we're not doing it right now?
So, Plan B is pissing me off by acting like you have a plan when you don't.
Maybe.
Plan B accomplished. What's Plan C?
I'm not going to tell you.
Fine. You're on your own. Later.
Agent Number Two stares out at the open sea. Suddenly, there is a woman.
Beautiful night, don't you think?
Hmm.
I love the way the moon is hitting the waves.
I love the way the moon is hitting Your eyes.
I love the way you're hitting on me.
Knock, knock.
What's there?
Man on a mission. Gotta go, beautiful.
Wait. Let me help you. I know my way around this ship very well.
Meanwhile, Rock Debris waits with suspicious patience inside the Hover Boy as Agent Number One watches.
How about a spin?
Is this what you're looking for?
Watch my back. Okay, party's over. Where's Fish?
I've got your back, lover boy. Do you like the way the moon is hitting my poison-tipped spear gun?
Put some clothes on or pull the trigger. I beg you.
Where would you like me to place it?
I figure Number One's a sure bet.
It's so flattering to have secret agents desperate to figure out what I'm up to. But all you had to do was ask.
Oh, yeah?
Thank you for asking. Tonight, with the help of Rock Debris...
You're going to fire off torpedoes and blow up Miami.
And?
Build a new Miami in all that crappy swampland you bought.
And?
Sell it all for a lot of money.
You don't even know the half of it. Rock has carefully aimed those torpedoes to start a devastating tidal wave. That way, splash, natural disaster.
So, no one gets blamed.
Exactly. Then, I donate the new Miami to the poor, homeless, rich people of old Miami.
Making you a very popular person.
Next, I'll introduce all my highly influential neighbors to my latest fad, Bavarian slap dancing to a crazy salsa beat.
What? Who's gonna go for that?
Everyone. The hypnotic beat of my salsa will mesmerize the international trendsetters of New Miami to do whatever I say. With my hypnotic powers, I'll turn my New Miami into an international fad factory.
Are you finished?
Are you kidding? Who knows what the next fad will be? I do, because it will be whatever I want it to be. Forever and ever, infinity, amen.
Sounds like one hell of a fish story.
Join me, Agent Number One. Get rid of Agent Number Two. You've always been my favorite agent. I've always hated Agent Number Two.
I am Agent Number Two.
Whatever, just kill the other one.
You're talking crazy, freak boy.
Am I? You mean to tell me you've never wanted to kill Agent Number One? I'm not going to tell you. I'm not going to tell you.
Patience.
I'm not going to tell you.
Never.
All right. You leave me no choice. Kill Agent Number One. Kill Agent Number One.
Yes, I will kill Agent Number One. Kill Agent Number One.
Moments later.
Hey, in case you're wondering, Plan C is working out exactly. This is definitely not part of Plan C.
Kill Agent Number One.
Locked in a death grip, the agents plunge overboard.
Release the psychotic killer porpoises!
Deranged, antisocial porpoises leap into the sea!
It's time to move over, Miami! Left, Tholtha!
Drop the remote, Fish!
The agents sail on deck, riding the psychotic porpoises!
No, you're supposed to be hypnotized.
Anti-hypno-contact lenses, Fish dude.
What about my psychotic killer porpoises?
All they needed was a few kind words. Luckily, I speak fluent porpoise.
Kill them! Kill the secret agent! Whole plan C.
Nice plan.
Mama.
Mission accomplished. One rotten fish on ice.
My day was going so well
Rock debris hits the sea as a submarine surfaces alongside the lover boy. It's Helena Troy.
Good work, boys. I've got it from here on out. Carlo, scoop that debris off my pretty sub.
You still don't even know what his plan was.
Oh, please. He was going to destroy Miami and build a new one and sell it.
You don't even know the half of it.
What was it?
I'm not going to tell you.
I have to pull that.
Well, maybe if you're patient, I'll tell you one day.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
But maybe if you planned a little bit, you wouldn't have gotten in trouble in the first place. You had to get yourself out of trouble.
I wasn't in trouble. I was in control the whole time. I had a plan. I put in the contacts, didn't I? Anti-hypno-contacts.
Right. Well, if you were not hypnotized, why did you attack me?
Because that was part of my plan. I had to attack
you. Part of your plan was to come back. I get it. Your plan was to put in anti-hypno-contacts so that you would not be hypnotized, so that you would have the opportunity to strangle me and throw me overboard.
Yes. I went overboard, too.
Boys, are you planning to shut up anytime soon? I need a drink.
He's just upset because he didn't make the plan. That's the thing.
That's the deal. No, I had the plan that actually saved the day. You would have just come back and shoved us into the water if we hadn't had
no,
it.
No,